Hi, this is Blake Angelos here at NAMM 2018 from Yamaha Corporation America here on Synthtopia to talk to you about the new firmware OS 2.0 for Montage. So big things about the new firmware is, first thing is we've always had all of the MOTIF XF voices. They've always been resonant in Montage as single part performances, but we didn't have all of the performances. Well, now you have access to all of the four part performances that that existed in the MOTIF XS, XF, and MOXF. And the great thing about it is when you bring them into the Montage, you can, what I like to say, montageify them. Because a Montage performance is actually eight parts. So you bring in four parts, you have an additional four parts to add new things like FMX parts, which is pretty cool. You can also bring to bear all of the cool motion control stuff to these performances, and they just sound better because the DSP in Montage has been significantly upgraded from the previous XF. So things just sound better, and the controllability is very cool. We also have 99 new performances that we added as well. But the first thing I'll show is what. So what can you do with these performances, the MOTIF XF performances? So I'll grab my live set here. Well, first off, it's just great to play these performances. There was one I used to use all the time, the one that's called the one I have right up here on the screen, if you look back there, called Schmoozen, because it's just kind of this cool. It's like instant fusion tune. So that's just, you know, just playing these performances that I, you know, love to play on the XF. They're all in here now. But more cool, or cooler than that even, is just the ability to take these performances and add some of the motion control stuff to it. Now, that's another thing that we added in OS version 2.0 is we... like, you know, I like to call them wormholes in the OS. Before, if you had to assign the super knob to do something, you have to go here and here, here maybe. Now it's a direct assignment to do certain things. So I'll show you how I can kind of montageify some of these performances. I was just playing with this one earlier. This is kind of a little trancey kind of. And this is from the MOTIF XF. I love this one because this is kind of a cool little groove. And I'll go ahead and I'll solo this little arpeggiated thing. So let's assign the super knob to do some things, and I'll do a couple of things here that I'll assign a new insertion effect that is specific to the Montage here. So how do I do that? I'm gonna hit edit on this part. I've selected this part and it's dropped me into my part settings. What I wanna do is kinda look at the filter. Now, as soon as I select any parameter like I've done here, I've selected the cutoff frequency of the filter, this control assign button lights up and it says, if you touch this, like I do, I can now assign a controller to something. So I'll just assign it to the super knob. So now I can, and it tells you at the top what happened at the upper levels of the performance is just information. But that's that easy to assign stuff. So the next thing I want to do is maybe drop into an insertion effect. And this one has, you can see up here, a VCM compressor and a template. Well, I'm going to change this compressor to one of the cool Montage effects. This effect I'll show you here is one that we added to OS version 1.6, and it's the spiralizer effect. Spiralizer, you can look up Shepard's tone sometimes to get an idea what the spiralizer does. But now when I select the parameters for that spiralizer effect, let's say just an easy one like this dry to wet mix. So I've selected that. This control assign lights up right here. I can assign the super knob on that. So now I have two assignments to the super knob. So I've montageified it, you know, and that's just the beginning that you can do. You could do a lot more. I could add more parts to it because I have an additional, what if I want to add an FMX part? Go in here, search by attribute. So now I'm only looking at FMX sounds, so now I've added another part here. FMX part. I'll show you some other cool things I love to do with these performances that kind of give them new life. One that I used to use all the time to show how cool the Motif XF orchestral sounds is this one called Winds and Strings. So this is from the Motif XF. And I used to play this all the time just to show how expressive our instruments are. That's one thing about, you know, our heart and soul is musical instruments, so even with synthesizers, that expressiveness. So nice, powerful sound. Well, right next to it, I have this orchestral brass swell. So this is a Montage performance, and this really shows like a fully baked super knob assigned sound. And I have the control over it with my foot controller pedal, so I'm controlling the super knob. And what this does, the orchestral or the actual orchestral brass will not only get louder, it will also become brighter. As you know, if you make a brass section get loud, not only do they get louder, the harmonics open up and they get, you know, the timbre changes. So this is a very powerful. So really dynamic. So what if I put those two performances together? I only have five more slots to add the four-part performance, which is cool. So I'll go ahead and touch that. And I'll use, you know, Montage has always had some pretty cool things about searching for stuff. And so the category search, if I just know that it's called Winds, and I just type it in, it shows up. There it is, Winds and Strings. And now I've merged these two performances. So I still have. I know, a super dynamic orchestra. But I still have one more part. What can I do there? I can touch this part, and I'll type in T-I-M-P for the first part of timpani. So now I have this cool timpani in there as well. But I want to do some more stuff with this timpani. So in version 1.5, again, this is the fourth major update we've had to the firmware. Each update brings new features, new sounds, new effects. So, and this one's no different. So I have this right here, and I'm going to change the view. And the view here is kind of cool. I can now see sort of an overview of all of the 16 parts of a performance. And I can see at a glance that 1 through 8 are active. So when I touch, I'm looking at the first four here. And when I touch a part, it actually gives me some information about that part. I know that this part has four elements in it. So I'll select the timpani over here. The 7-element timpani, it's quite a timpani. It's got a lot of dynamic range. And I'm going to go ahead and select that box below. And you see it says range. Well, that's the velocity range. And now the screen changes over here, and it shows me that little cross is showing what the velocity is and where it is on the keyboard I'm hitting. So what I want to do is I want to velocity compress, I guess, this timpani so that it only engages when I hit it pretty hard. So I see it right there. Now, if I like it, I touch the keyboard, and now I've set that number. So now, if I go above 112, it will trigger the timpani. I'll put it a little higher because I kind of want it to, 124 to 127. So I really got to hit it to get that timpani. Now, I turn off the keyboard so it doesn't keep selecting it, and then I'll touch the EQ effects. And because I'm pointing at that part, only the reverb for that part will go up. Now, if I touch the top of the performance, it would increase the reverb across the entire performance. But if I drop down one level to that part here, and I turn the reverb up, now I have this huge timpani. So when I hit it, So what did I do? I grabbed this orchestral brass swell. I found that Motif XF performance. I added those two together, added the timpani. And if I wasn't talking so much, I could have done that in 30 seconds. So it's really fast to get around to do these type of cool things with this older content from the Motif XF, bringing it together with the new stuff inside of Montage. I'll show you some other cool things, too. We have this cloud-based app that's on YamahaSynth.com called FM Converter. And what FM Converter allows you to do is to take DX7, DX72, TX816, TX802, a few other ones. It says all the products it is, but that's a whole lot of voices from our 80s DX library. But the thing that's cool is that you can take these files from the DX7, from these older vintage FM synthesizers, drop them into FM Converter, hit Convert, and it spits out a Montage file so that you can load in DX7 sounds directly into Montage. And I have one here. This is actually Brass 3 from the original DX7 ROM 1 cartridge. And when it brings it in just like it would be in a DX7 with no effects. So what can I do? I'm going to montageify this using the FMX engine. The FMX engine is a lot more powerful. It's got some more features. And plus, you have all the DSP. DX7 didn't have any DSP at all. So I can add some reverb and stuff. But I'll go ahead and I'll assign the super knob to some FM parameters and just talk about the fact that you have real-time control over FM, because that's the great thing about Montage, is that you can assign them to parameters. Direct synthesizer parameters. It's a lot bigger than just MIDI controllers. We're talking about getting into the resonant of... I'll show you. I'll just... rather than talk about it. So here's Brass 3. Edit. Select the part. So now I'm looking at this. First of all, you see that there's 8 operators. DX7 only had 6 operators. And the idea... I love this, and I keep using this now, and it to explain in a nutshell what FM synthesis is. Best, absolute best explanation I've ever heard. You have carriers and modulators. So if you think about a violin, it's sort of analogous to just playing a note on a violin. The carrier would be when I bow the string, you hear that. The modulator would be like vibrato. If I'm not bowing the string and I'm just moving my hand, you don't hear that because it affects the sound, the carrier. So the modulator is the vibrato, the carrier is the bow and the sound of the violin. So if I affect a modulator, it can do a lot of pretty radical things to the sound. The modulator actually in FM, what it does is it increases sideband partial. So it brings in overtones and makes this wave a lot more interesting. So I'm gonna use, number 6 is a pretty powerful one because I see that's where the feedback loop is. So, and it's also a modulator. So I'm gonna change, first of all, from sine wave. So DX7 only had sine waves. We have some other harmonic spectra that allow for some deeper, more interesting kind of waveform. So I'll select the resonant waveform here, and then I'll just adjust the resonance. So you hear that's going to be a pretty powerful. That really changes the sound. Well, I want to assign that. Again, anything that is assignable parameter will show up right there. So I want to assign it. Done. I just assigned it to the super knob. So now, so already I've got something very different with this FM, this DX7 sound. Another thing that DX7 didn't have is a filter, a resonant filter, a synth filter. And my explanation for filters are like blankets. So a low-pass filter would be like if I took a blanket and started at my feet and rolled it up over my head. So as I move it up, I'm changing the cutoff frequency. High-pass filters, if I started from my head and went down, and then maybe a band-pass filter is if I just had it over my midsection and moved it around this way. So I'm going to apply a resonant filter here. How about the 24... And there's 18, you can see all these filter types, lots of choices here. I'll do the low pass filter analog style filter. And again, touch the cutoff frequency and I see right here, oh look, the control assign lights up. So now I've applied 2 parameters. Kind of a cool bass sound almost. And then the last thing I'll do is I'll just apply effects. Again, when we bring these over from the DX7, it brings them in just like how they were in the DX7. No effects, no filter, no anything. But I can now add some cool effects to this. How about something like a VCM phaser? And with this one, what will I do for this guy? So I'll drop down into the phaser here. And how about we change something like, I don't know, feedback? Control assign, what do I want to assign it to? Now, I should point out here that before we didn't have the ability in this control assign. We've always been able to do this control assign thing, but it's a little bit easier to assign things to things like the motion sequencer or an envelope follower if I want, because Montage has this cool envelope follower. I'll play that in a second too. But how about if I just do, I don't know, how about aftertouch? So I just assigned something to aftertouch by pressing into it. So now, the feedback of the phaser increases as I as I adjust that. So that's what I mean about montageifying these DX7 sounds. That's just, you know, that's very cool. Very cool. Speaking of envelope follower, just since I was here, I brought it up. A lot of people don't realize that there is this cool envelope follower in here. So I have this this groove I have here called Follow the Trap Kit. So when I play the first part, I don't have the ARP on. It's just this. Now imagine this drum that's going to come in here is coming in through the A to D input that I have, like maybe our EAD system in here that can grab the drums and mic them really effectively. I can bring that in and get a solid signal, and something like this can happen. So what you're going to hear here is when I play the sound that you just heard, I have the drums feeding the filters of two of the parts so that when the drums play, the envelope follower follows. And it's cool what this does. I was experimenting with different drums grooves. See, if I turn off the ARP, envelope follower is no more. But now I'll turn on the ARP. Check this out. Some of these. See these drums? This one's a cool one. And this groove. That's just really cool. And all you're doing, or all I'm doing, is holding a single chord, and it's like right with the drummer. That's so cool. So version 2.0, in a nutshell, Motif XF performance capability, so you can load. And when you think about with the FM converter and Motif XF, XS performances, Mo XF performances, you really have access to probably arguably the largest synth library on the planet with all of that stuff that you can put into Montage. 99 new performances and a host of new just usability features to get around and do these edits quickly and easily. If you want more information about what's in version 2.0, go to yamahasynth.com. There's a version 2.0 article. There's a great video by you might see Dom Sigalis around here. He's going to be up here as well from Yamaha Music Europe. There's Dom right there. So Dom did a wonderful quick video that seemingly he did in about 5 minutes, and it looks like totally produced quality. So that I embedded that in the article so you can watch a little video of it, and then there's all of the features are listed. The update will appear on yamaha.com. You go to www.yamaha.com. You go to the Montage page. That's where you'll find the download on February 7th, so in a couple weeks here. It'll be available for download, and you'll be able to do all these things and have access to this. So that's all I have for you today. For more information, hang out and watch Synthtopia, my favorite site for synth information. And once again, this is Blake Angelos from NAMM 2018, Yamaha Corporation America. Thanks for watching.